Bill Cosby coming at you with music and fun, and if you're not careful, you may learn something before it's done. So let's get ready, okay?
Hey, hey, hey!
This is really hard work. Of course, nothing's really hard work unless you'd rather be doing something else. This old clock, I dig it. My uncle had one just like it. And the alarm never worked. Neither did he. Of course, this uncle of mine had his own ideas about work. He used to say, early to bed and early to rise. Makes a lot of money for the other guys. A lot of dudes still have that idea about work. Like Fat Albert and the gang. They got the idea that unless a job is real glamorous, like a sports hero or an actor, it just isn't worth doing. But I think their ideas about jobs are going to be reworked.
Well, class, I know everyone is prepared with the special project I assigned you. And you're all anxious to report on your father's occupations, aren't you?
Yay! Yes,
right on! Right on.
Yay!
Now, who wants to be first?
I want to go first.
Now. Well, Donald.
What Donald's dad does! By Donald!
No class.
My father is the world's greatest animal trainer. He trains lions and tigers and hippopots, mooses, and polo bears. One day, my father was training a vicious alligator. And the alligator leaped over my father's head, and he got away. And he went through the city scaring everybody. And then he climbed up a big building, and he started grabbing an airplane. But my father was too smart for him. He bought himself a helicopter, and flew over the building, and he threw a net over, and he caught him. And that's what my father does. You're truly Donald.
Thank you, Donald. Well, Bucky, tell us about your father.
My father's a big business tycoon.
Typhoon?
My father travels everywhere in his private limousine making big business deals. My father hauls in so much money, he can't even count it. My father is so important, even his license number is unlisted. The end.
Uh-huh, I see. All right, Bill, you're next.
My dad, the secret agent.
What? Mom, louder! I can't hear you.
Yes, Bill, speak up.
My dad, the secret agent. The end.
What?
What you mean, the end?
What my dad does is so secret, I can't tell anybody.
Harold?
Underneath the ocean top with my pop. Every morning, my pop goes to work in a submarine as far down as 20,000 leagues.
Don't you mean leagues?
Uh-huh. And my pop has to fight off vicious tiger sharks. And lion sharks. And leopard sharks. And all kinds of sharks. And an octopus. But my pop's real job is to pick up sucking treasure chests. And to give all the money to charity, like the old pirates' home. And that's what my pop does.
Next, please.
My father, the big movie star.
To be or not to be? That is the question.
I became be talk about my father now because he was a harbor saving.
Rudy, may we hear your story?
Yours truly's father, the antique collector.
Oh, come on, Rudy.
Cool it, man.
Yeah, get out of here.
What's your problem, man?
Continue, Rudy.
My father travels far and wide, collecting objects d'arte.
What?
Objects d'arte. You know, things you find in museums. Like the Louvre.
You mean objects to art in the Louvre, I take it. But go on.
Anyway, He collects lots of neo things.
You mean like your house and your car?
No, expensive arty stuff. Like the Statue of Liberty and old comic books. And he sells it for lots of money. That's what my father does.
Very well, Rudy. And now, Fat Albert.
Hey. Wait till you hear what I got to say. My dad is the world's greatest heavyweight boxer. Nobody ever hit him. They call him Old Hammer Fist. And when it comes to fancy footwork, nobody can touch him. Yes, sir. There isn't a better boxer in the world than my father.
Well, I have to commend you for your highly imaginative dissertations. However, now I would like to know what your fathers really do. Fat Albert, your father's not a boxer, is he?
Oh, yes, ma'am. He is. He boxes a lot of things at the warehouse.
And Rudy, your father isn't a knot collector, is he?
Well, he is a collector. A junk collector.
And you, your father's not a movie star, is he?
Well, he be toppy in front of an audience on a tour bus.
And now, Harold, tell us the real story about your father, the submarine captain.
Well, he does work on a boat. A tugboat.
Bill?
Well, my dad isn't exactly a secret agent. He's more sort of like a night watchman.
And Bucky? What kind of big businessman is your father?
He sells brushes.
And Donald? What does your father really do with animals?
He's a dog catcher.
Now, quiet. There's nothing to laugh at. There's something important about everybody's job, and it's vital that you learn that for yourselves. So I'm going to give you all a special outside assignment.
Special assignment?
What's this?
Special? Outside?
Hey, special.
What's going on?
But before I do that, I'm phoning all your parents.
Oh, boy, Miss Breifogel's gonna phone the kid's parents. That usually means bad news. But maybe there's less than meets the eye. It's just possible Miss Breifogel has something other than punishment in mind.
Uh-huh. Yes, Miss Breifogel. Mm-hmm. Albert did what? Mm-hmm. Uh-oh. Uh-huh. I think that's an excellent idea. I'll take care of it right away. Goodbye. Albert? Albert, come here. You know where you're going?
To jail?
What? No. You're coming to work with me.
Huh?
Yeah. All your classmates are going to work with their fathers.
But I can't go on no job. I'm too young to work, Dad.
No. It's just for one day. Miss Breifogel wants you kids to see what our jobs are really like. And I think it's a great idea.
You mean we don't have to go to school?
That's right.
Hey, let's be on our way.
Well, what do you think of the junk business, son?
N.C.
N.C.?
No class.
Listen, I'm junking a car out back. You keep an eye on things while I'm gone.
Phooey. Hey, kid, where'd you get this genuine 1912 Chicago elevated station gun machine?
Huh?
I've been looking for one of these for years.
What? That old thing?
Oh, being cagey, huh? I'll bet you want a bundle for it. And how about this? A genuine Atwater Camp Super Heterodyne.
Looks like an old radio to me.
Oh, and look at that. That phonograph is a classic.
Classic?
Rudy, I need the tool chip. Oh, good day, sir.
Say, you've got some wonderful items here. Who would have thought you could find such treasure in a junkyard?
What were you saying about no class?
Man, this tugboat stuff is the slowest.
Well, we're not built for speed, but these big ships couldn't do without us. That dude's asking for trouble.
I don't know, but it sure looks cool to me.
He's headed right for our line.
Oh, my gosh, he tipped over.
Tell the skipper to sound the alarm. Harold, stand by with the life preserve. Throw me the life preserve. You gonna be all right? Too bad I can't say that for your boat.
I don't know how to thank you for saving my life.
You can thank me by doing me two favors.
What's that?
Always wear a life jacket.
What's the other favor?
Don't pile the boat like a fool.
Do me a favor, Dad.
Sure, Harold.
What? Help me learn how to work on a tugboat.
That's right. The shipment is on Dock 8 and taken to the flat car ramp. Right?
Hey, Dad.
Just a minute, Albert. What? That order absolutely has to be out for 3 o'clock. Mm-hmm.
Dad.
No, no, Albert. Use your head.
I can't get the boxes up that high.
Use the forklift. No, no, not you. I was talking to my son. Listen, I'll get back to you. You shouldn't lift heavy loads like that. Put the boxes down. Mm-hmm.
Man, Dad, the guys really work hard around here. You ought to get shorter hours.
Shorter hours?
Yeah, 60 minutes is too long.
It only seems that way because you're unfamiliar with the job. And you know the old saying, Albert. If at first you don't succeed, you're about average. Mm-hmm. Okay, Albert, get up in the seat here, and I'll show you how to run this thing. Darn it, I'll have to get that. Just wait here.
Hey, 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 this is okay.
Albert! Hit the brake!
I hate to cut in like this when Fat Albert is headed for that big pile of boxes, but I'd like to say just one thing. Look out!
Albert! Albert! Are you all right?
Except I feel all boxed in.
Lucky those paper cartons were empty, but Fat Albert would have made a pretty package himself.
Who been feeding you those wild stories about dog catchers? Everybody knows dog catchers like to lock up dogs and put them to sleep forever. No, no, Donald. Nobody enjoys destroying dogs. Matter of fact, we find homes for lots and lots of them every day. You mean you find a home for every loose dog? No, but we try. What's happening, Dad?
Here, doggy. Here, doggy. Come on out of there.
Come on, Donald. We got work to do. Look out, officer. That's not such a good idea.
Man, am I ever glad you're here. You take over.
Quick, Donald. Run back to the truck and get my rescue kit.
Stop, thief. He's kidnapping my Broderick.
There, there, Broderick. Mama's here. The bad old dog catcher won't hurt you now.
Gee, Dad. I never knew how tough your job really was.
Officer, arrest that man.
No, I won't arrest him. But I have a citation for you.
What's this?
There's a leash law in this town. And also, your dog has no license tag.
What? This is an outrage. I'll have your badge for this.
Gosh! The things we public servants had to put up with.
Oh, no. Another one of those time clocks. I bet we checked 11,800 million of them already.
No part of the job, Bill. Hey, come on.
Nothing ever happens on this job.
Now, that's why I'm here, to see that nothing happens.
Darn it, anyway. Didn't want to come here in the first place. This is a drag of drags. Golly.
Shh, quiet, quiet, quiet.
I don't hear nothing.
Wait here.
Huh? What's going on? We got robbers? Don't go in there, Dad. Oh. Don't go back in there, Dad. The police are coming. Let them do it.
No, no. That's the fire department. There was a small fire in the warehouse, but the automatic sprinklers put it out.
You mean there's no robbers?
Not this time, no.
Well, son, you can be proud of your dad here. Saved us a lot of work.
But he didn't put the fire out.
No. But he saved thousands of dollars worth of merchandise from water damage when he turned the automatic sprinklers off.
Yeah, Chief. Me and Pop, we like to keep on top of things, you know? This car business is tricky stuff. We gotta know what we're doing, you know? We gotta keep a close eye on everybody and everything. And even though it looks like ain't nothing going on, it probably is. And that's why we're here.
Well, I must compliment the class on the reports you've given on your father's jobs.
Do you all think you learned something?
Yeah, we sure did.
You bet.
Right on.
I be don't be know but nothing about but my dad is tour of the business.
You didn't? Why not?
I missed the barbers.
Poor Mushmouth. He not only missed the bus, he missed the boat. Because all the other kids have learned something. They learned that no matter what your job is, if you do it right, it's important. And the kids even wrote a song about that. Sing that song, kids.
Everybody's job is important in helping everybody, you and me.
What if you didn't have a doctor? You can't always take care of yourself. And what if there were no policemen?
Everybody's job is important in helping everybody, you and me.
What if we didn't have a trash man picking up your garbage all the time? And what about the good old sign maker? Why'd you get lost?
Everybody's job is important in helping everybody, you and me. Everybody's job is important, each and every one of the 17. Everybody's job is important in helping everybody, you and me.
Cosby coming at you with music and fun, and if you're not careful, you may learn something before it's done. So let's get ready, okay?
Hey, hey, hey!
Of course, nothing's really hard work unless you'd rather be doing something else. This old clock, I dig it. My uncle had one just like it, and the alarm never worked. Neither did he. Of course, this uncle of mine had his own ideas about work. He used to say, early to bed and early to rise. Makes a lot of money for the other guys. A lot of dudes still have that idea about work. Like Fat Albert and the gang. They got the idea that unless a job is real glamorous, like a sports hero or an actor, it just isn't worth doing. But I think their ideas about jobs are going to be reworked.
Well, class, I know everyone is prepared with the special project I assigned you. And you're all anxious to report on your father's occupations, aren't you?
Yay! Yes, right on!
Now, who wants to be first?
I want to go!
I'll go first!
Hey, Minnie!
No! Let me go first!
Now. Well, Donald.
What Donald's dad does!
by Donald.
No class.
My father is the world's greatest animal trainer. He trains lions and tigers and hippopots, mooses, and polo bears. One day, my father was training a vicious alligator. And the alligator leaped over my father's head, and he got away. And he went through the city scaring everybody. And then he climbed up a big building, and he started grabbing an airplane. But my father was too smart for him. He bought himself a helicopter and flew over the building and he flew in over and he caught him. And that's what my father does. You're truly Donald.
Thank you, Donald. Well, Bucky, tell us about your father.
My father's a big business typhoon.
Typhoon?
My father travels everywhere in his private limousine making big business deals.
What you mean, the end?
What my dad does is so secret, I can't tell anybody.
Harold?
Underneath the ocean top with my pop. Every morning, my pop goes to work in a submarine as far down as 20,000 leagues.
Don't you mean leagues?
Uh-huh. And my pop has to fight off vicious tiger sharks. And lion sharks. And leopard sharks. And all kinds of sharks. And an octopus. But my pop's real job is to pick up sucking treasure chests. And to give all the money to charity, like the old pirate's home. And that's what my pop does.
Next, please.
Maybe father, the big movie star.
To be or not to be? That is the question.
I became be talk about my father now because he was a behavior saver.
Rudy, may we hear your story?
Yours truly's father, the antique collector.
Oh, come on, Rudy.
Cool it, man.
Yeah, get out of here.
Dude, what's your problem, man?
Continue, Rudy.
My father travels far and wide, collecting objects d'arte.
What?
Objects d'arte. You know, things you find in museums, like the Louvre.
You mean objects d'art in the Louvre, I take it. But go on.
Anyway, he collects lots of neo things.
You mean like your house and your car?
No, expensive arty stuff. Like the Statue of Liberty and old comic books. And he sells them for lots of money. That's what my father does.
Very well, Rudy. And now, Fat Albert.
Hey, hey, hey. Wait till you hear what I got to say. My dad is the world's greatest heavyweight boxer. Nobody ever hit him. They call him Old Hammer Fist. And when it comes to fancy footwork, nobody can touch him. Yes, sir. There isn't a better boxer in the world than my father.
Well, I have to commend you for your highly imaginative dissertations. However, now I would like to know what your fathers really do. Fat Albert, your father's not a boxer, is he?
Oh, yes, ma'am. He is. He boxes a lot of things at the warehouse.
And Rudy, your father isn't a knot collector, is he?
Well, he is a collector. A junk collector.
And you... Your father's not a movie star, is he?
Robbie, he be talking in front of an audience on a tour bus.
And now, Harold, tell us the real story about your father, the submarine captain.
He means bad news. But maybe there's less than meets the eye. It's just possible Miss Breyfogle has something other than punishment in mind.
Uh-huh. Yes, Miss Breyfogle. Mm-hmm. Albert did what? I think that's an excellent idea. I'll take care of it right away. Goodbye. Albert? Albert, come here. You know where you're going?
To jail?
What? No. You're coming to work with me.
Huh?
Yeah. All your classmates are going to work with their fathers.
But I can't go on no job. I'm too young to work, Dad.
No, no. It's just for one day. Miss Breyfogle wants you kids to see what our jobs are really like. and I think it's a great idea.
You mean we don't have to go to school?
That's right.
Hey, 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 let's be on our way.
Well, what do you think of the junk business, son?
N.C.
N.C.?
No class.
Listen, I'm junking a car out back. You keep an eye on things while I'm gone.
Fooey.
Hey, kid, where'd you get this genuine 1912 Chicago elevated station gum machine?
Huh?
I've been looking for one of these for years.
What? That old thing?
Oh, being cagey, huh? I'll bet you want a bundle for it. And how about this? A genuine Atwater Kemp Super Heterodyne.
Looks like an old radio to me.
Oh, and look at that. That phonograph is a classic.
Classic?
Rudy, I need the tool check.
Oh, good day, sir.
Say, you've got some wonderful items here. Who would have thought you could find such treasure in a junkyard?
What were you saying about no class?
Man, this tugboat stuff is the slowest.
Well, we're not built for speed, but these big ships couldn't do without us. That dude's asking for trouble.
I don't know, but it sure looks cool to me.
Uh-oh, he's headed right for our line.
Oh, my gosh, he tipped over.
Tell the skipper to sound the alarm. Harold, stand by with the life preserver. Throw me the life preserver. You gonna be all right? Too bad I can't say that for your boat.
I don't know how to thank you for saving my life.
You can thank me by doing me two favors.
What's that?
Always wear a life jacket.
What's the other favor?
Don't pile the boat like a fool.
Do me a favor, Dad.
Sure, Harold. What?
Help me learn how to work on a tugboat.
That's right. The shipment is on Dock 8 and taken to the flat car ramp. Right?
Hey, Dad.
Just a minute, Albert. What? That order absolutely has to be out for 3 o'clock. Mm-hmm. And you know the old saying, Albert. If at first you don't succeed, you're about average.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, Albert, get up in the seat here, and I'll show you how to run this thing. Darn it, I'll have to get that. Just wait here.
Hey, 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 this is okay.
Albert! Hit the brake!
I hate to cut in like this when Fat Albert is headed for that big pile of boxes, but I'd like to say just one thing. Look out!
Albert! Albert! Are you all right?
Except I feel all boxed in.
Lucky those paper cartons were empty, but Fat Albert would have made a pretty package himself.
Who been feeding you those wild stories about dog catchers? Everybody knows dog catchers like to lock up dogs and put them to sleep forever. No, no, Donald. Nobody enjoys destroying dogs. Matter of fact, we find homes for lots and lots of them every day.
You mean you find a home for every loose dog?
No, but we try.
What's happening, Dad?
Here, doggy. Here, doggy. Come on out of there.
Come on, Donald. We got work to do. Look out, officer. That's not such a good idea.
Man, am I ever glad you're here. You take over.
Quick, Donald. Run back to the truck and get my rescue kit.
Stop, thief. He's kidnapping my Broderick.
There, there, Broderick. Mama's here. The bad old dog catcher won't hurt you now.
Hey, Dad. I never knew how tough your job really was.
Officer, arrest that man.
No, I won't arrest him. But I have a citation for you.
What's this?
There's a leash law in this town. And also, your dog has no license tag.
What? This is an outrage. I'll have your badge for this.
Gosh! The things we public servants had to put up with.
Oh, no. Another one of those time clocks. I bet we checked 1,100 million of them already.
No part of the job, Bill. Hey, come on.
Nothing ever happens on this job.
Now, that's why I'm here, to see that nothing happens.
Darn it, anyway. Didn't want to come here in the first place. This is a drag of drags. Golly.
Shh, quiet, quiet, quiet.
I don't don't hear nothing.
Wait here.
Huh? What's going on? We got robbers? Don't go in there, Dad. Oh. Don't go back in there, Dad.